Hello and welcome to Andy Matters ECR Science Hacks, and today we're talking about everyone's boring science friend, writing for peer review. Writing a paper for peer review is like taking something you love and have cared for and removing its soul in order to preserve it for eternity. I like to think of every paper I've written as a beautiful taxidermied pet. Now, getting into the headspace for writing is one of the most difficult things you'll ever do. Now, I'm really pleased to tell you that there is no such thing as a bad or good time for writing. You're going to hate every second of it. The biggest thing holding people back from starting writing is this so-called writer's block. Now, another myth I'm really happy to bust is there's no such thing as writer's block. It's just you realizing how shit your writing is. As you type, you'll feel a sense of embarrassment as you watch your shittiness appear on the screen. But don't worry, there'll be plenty of people willing to give you advice that you never even asked for. For a lot of career academics, the title is the only thing they'll read before citing the paper, so you need to make sure that it's catchy, and research has shown that anything under about 16 words makes it much more citable. The abstract summarizes how you performed your research and also what you learned. This is the only part of the paper that most scientists will read, so if you get it just right, you'll get extra citations. Your introduction section should summarize all of the previous work so that people understand the significance of your work. Be sure to include words like thus, nonetheless, therefore, and other words that make you feel better than everyone else. This is where you show all of the graphs and data that led to your conclusions. And this is where most people go wrong, is they need to show less confusing graphs, not more. Someone should be able to read the methods section and repeat your study with their sample. But in reality, this never really happens because that just doesn't get grant funding. And in the conclusion section, you'll summarize all of the results and come up with a fanciful application like invisibility cloak or popular one, Terminator. By using the phrase, this may be used for, you'll save a load of questions and comments from the reviewers. When you've finished each of these sections, you need to get other people to read it. The more eyes that see this paper, the better. Now, you'll end up hating each person that gives you feedback, but don't worry. The university provides 4 free counseling sessions each year, and you can save your hatred for these sessions. After countless hours of revisions and edits, it can be quite difficult to know exactly when to submit your paper. It's simple. If every time you open the document, you get a dull ache in this area of your body, it's time to submit. Now, at this point, you're probably feeling pretty proud of yourself. But remember that although papers are the prized currency of academia, they mean almost nothing to people in the real world. In that regard, papers are like Bitcoin that you can't even buy drugs with.